Hey guys, welcome back to Legend of Grimrock 2. Sorry, I guess it's been a while since my last episode. I didn't actually really notice how much time had passed. I kind of made a mistake. Things got chaotic, had a bunch of work to do, and just got distracted with shit I had to take care of. But anyway, since it's been a while since our last episode, that means you guys had plenty of time to comment on my previous videos, so I have like a full page of notes here on my little notepad here. And so we're going to be doing a lot of cleanup in this episode. And then whenever I finish with my cleanup, which should be in this episode, hopefully, I'll move on to the next zone I haven't been to yet, I believe, which is that place over here. Because I don't know what's over there. But I've gone, like, most other directions I could go for at this point. So I guess I know it's a cemetery. Because I stepped foot in it once and then walked back. I'm like, oh crap, this isn't where I thought I was. But anyway, I have things to take care of. Someone offered a solution for a puzzle at the pyramid. Many people pointed out the fact that I forgot to do the whole, like, this glutton got, or whatever, was, like, held in six caskets. So that's obviously, I need to put the mirror gauntlets there. I'm gonna fight those golems. I'm going to grab those items I left behind in some of the puzzles. And then, I'm gonna do some more puzzles outside. The teleport puzzle, the foreign language puzzle, and I might find a secret boss. Alright, you guys might remember this is the place where you have to teleport in, and that gives you access to this chest. And what I missed here is there's a button right here. Ta-da! Which should open a door, right here. Ta-da! So I missed this for a while, but here we go. It's another one of those stone circles that's clearly meant for the horn that I haven't been using very much. Which I may have not brought the horn with me. I didn't bring the horn with me. Okay, I'll be back with the horn. I'm stupid. Alrighty, so we're back at the place with the secret, and it turns out I had the horn summoning with me the whole time, and I ran all the way back for nothing, because I'm stupid. Thank God for editing, I guess, but let's blow this and find out how fucked I am. It has to be in his hand, doesn't it? We'll replace the rope for now. And then I died horribly. Where is it? Oh god, all the rocks are gonna wake up? Dispel? Hey asshole. Vroom! That was not effective at all. There we go. Oh. Okay, this might be a fun little problem, isn't it? Really, dispel doesn't do shit. I thought dispel was supposed to do bonus damage against, elementals. Okay, well the good news is their health bar is going down, so I'm about to get trapped. Oh no! Okay. That's how you fuck up. Okay, he's dead. Okay, the skull. My magic user's dead. That went very poorly, very quickly. And apparently, apparently everyone does shit damage to these guys except for my very awesome, warrior. Okay, we're fine. Even though I fucked up immediately and got trapped like that and my mage died, we're doing just fine. Because these assholes are slow and dumb, and I have a giant rock on the end of a stick from space. It's from space, motherfucker. It's from space. You're not dead yet. I keep thinking you're gonna die when I say space. That's why I'm putting so much emphasis on the word. Die. I did it. Having a nice time. It's a geology joke, because nice is a type of rock. It's a metamorphic rock. Tome of Knowledge. It gains one skill point. Okay, I'll do a quick look through my characters and figure out who needs a skill point. And I'll also get back to a freaking healing stone, because I'm gonna fucking die here. Well, thankfully it's pretty safe outside. So I'm not in that much danger for that reason. Let's pick up these rocks that got dropped everywhere, because they might be handy for puzzles someday. Probably not, but that was a hiccup. Thanks for watching, guys. I'll be back when I get, I'll go heal, and we'll head towards one of my next things. Alrighty then, rock throwing puzzle, take 17. Pshoom! Is there already something on the pressure plate? Whoopsie. Alright. Rock throwing puzzle, take 18. I'm increasing the number on my joke number I made up. Pshoom! There we go. Oh! That took me right back where I was. Okay, so middle one takes you there. And the closest one takes you right back to the teleport spot, I think, so let's try this again. This one! Where am I? Storm Seed Orb! I don't know what that is. It's probably a spellcasting item. Energy 15, dexterity plus 2. Okay. It shoots a lightning bolt. What is that? I see enemies out there. Oh no, the mummy! All the pyramid enemies are coming outside now. No! Okay, this thing... Oh, it has charges. That's a bummer. I already can shoot lightning bolts, can't I? I don't think I need this so much. So, 15 energy, 2 dexterity. Versus... 15 en... Was it... Oh, 20... Yeah, 15 energy, 15 energy. So, it can shoot lightning bolts, or this one can make me light up. I mean, it's a cool item to just find, but I think I'm just going to hold on to my Orb of Radiance because it helps me see and never use torches. Because I don't need the ability to shoot lightning bolts so much. Where am I, though? So right over there is still that goddamn elemental temple that I can't get to. One of these days, something's going to reveal how the hell I get there. Ow! Ow. How do I get... I need to get back on the mainland. Oh no, there's mermen, too. Those weren't there a second ago, were they? Whatever, I'll just come up here. There we go. Hey, asshole, how you doing? You having a good time? I'm gonna blow you up now. Krung. You didn't die. You're supposed to die. I'll shoot you in the face. Please die. You're being very rude by continuing to survive. I don't appreciate your glib attitude. Die? You're not obeying the things I tell you to do. Oh, that was a terrible cast. Let's try that again. Oh, God. We faked each other out. She's just becoming an all-around problem, isn't she? Ring! There we go, she's dead. Well, she was a pain. There we go, teleporter puzzle finally fully taken care of. I kept thinking that there wasn't any more to it, but I guess so. Next, we'll do the weird language thing, and then we'll go back to the pyramid for all the stuff I missed there. Alright, welcome back to the Ruins of Desaruun / the Lexiconary. Lexiconary, I don't know. The place we've been at a long time ago, and this was the first super long dungeon we ever found. And we're back at this pressure plate puzzle, which I solved this one of. Uhuna nada blah 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 blah. Wait, I didn't solve this one. Te uhuna pala, so on and so forth. So what happened here is someone kinda spoiled this puzzle for me, but I ignored their spoiler for the longest time because I figured at some point there would be a note that I would find, and that note would tell me how to solve this, because I figured we have this... Where is it? Where's the language note? Somewhere in here. Language note. So many notes. So many notes. How do I keep track of them all? Oh shit, did I lose it? These are all spells. Map. These are all... Did I put it away? Oh, there we go. There we go. So, this is interesting. So, I did a little looking around, because I don't like spoiling things for myself, but I did want to research whether or not I would eventually find a note explaining what Pala and Fom mean, because, I'm going to put this here where I can find it easier. This thing has, it says Te Uhuna Pala, so it's like, it's all the stuff that I've seen before. We previously solved the fact that Ko means three, which we figured out because they gave us that A and Na mean one and two, and I reached a point where I'm like, I found that note in the Twigroot Forest where I understood every word except for Ko, and Ko, because of its location in the sentence, had to be a number, because it's the number of steps you take. So I just went ahead and tried moving three through process of elimination, because one and two were different things, and that worked. So now I know Ko means three from that puzzle. But I did a little looking around online, and it turns out, at least according to people, they said that there's no notes that actually tells you what Pala and Fom mean, so you're supposed to just figure it out on your own. And so I guess the way you're supposed to figure this out, because I'm actually looking at this scroll here, and what I realize here is that if you look at all of the... If you look at the orientation of these notes, they're all laid out in like a 2x6 frame. If you look at those, the two ones that say rotate, there's two that indicate rotation, and those ones are blank. And if you look at it, you control this game with QWEASD, six, it's a 2x6 series of letters. So presumably Pala and Fom are literally like Q and E, like the two rotation buttons. This will be confusing for me because I actually remapped the buttons so that A and D were my rotation buttons, but I'm sure I can figure it out anyway. But the question is, which one's Pala and which one's Fom? So we're gonna have to figure that out by process of elimination. I've written down the note, though. I've had this written down ever since we first came here. So, I'm going to see if I can figure this out. I think you start here in the middle, right? So, the first one is Tay. Tay means turn right, move right. And, let's see, Uhu means forward. Na Pala Uhu means damn it, I'm forgetting how this works. let's take a look at this. Uhuna. That's weird. Okay. See, this is weird because these all say this direction, this number, this direction, this number, this direction, this number. This one just says Te. So it just says right. But it doesn't say a number for it. So that's a little weird. Maybe if I just try moving once to the right, I guess? So, Tay 1. Okay, so... Or maybe it means to go all the way to the right. I don't know. But, Uhu Na would be one, 2 forward. Pala Uhu, I think... So the question is, does Pala mean left or right? Let's see. They're going to say... They're telling me to move forward once. Let's say that Pala means turn right. So, Uhu Na is... Nope. No, Pala must mean turn left, because you can't turn right and move forward twice, so... Pala must mean left, so Uhu Na again. Pala. Na. So turn left, and then move forward. R-A is move right once. Fom-Ko should mean turn right, and then move 3 times. Ah, we can't. We can only move forward twice. So, we'll just finish it anyway. Down, Ko. So, Lam, Ko. So, that's not going to work. So, I have not solved the puzzle. So, the biggest question is, what does it mean when it says Te? Just on its own. Let's assume that Te means move all the way to the right. So, just as far right as possible, I guess. Okay, so Uhu Na is forward twice. Pala Uhu means you go left and you go, okay, so we go left and move forward twice. Pala Na means turn left and move twice. Does that make sense? R-A means move right once. Fam Ko means turn right, move forward 3 times. Lam Ke means go backwards 3 times. I mean sorry, Fom Ko Lam Ko. Nope, I've failed to figure this out. Alright, I'm gonna keep trying, and when I succeed, I'll show you that guy's that attempt, because obviously we don't need to sit here and run around in circles for 17 years, but I'm missing something basic here. I'll explain it after I figure it out. Okay, I'm looking at my notes here, I'm writing them down, and while I was trying to... instead of just writing down the runes and looking at the scroll the whole time, I tried translating them by hand, and I'm realizing when it says Pala Na or Fam Ko, it might not mean... I don't think it means to rotate and then move that much. I think it means rotate that many times, because I'm noticing there's no... There's never a Pala A. There's a Pala Na and there's a Fam Ko, meaning 2 and 3, but they don't indicate a number for rotating 1. So they might mean rotate twice or rotate 3 times. So let's try this again. So I'm going to assume that whenever it doesn't say A, when it doesn't have an E, it just means 1 by default. So let's try my new instruction. So Te is right 1. Well, I was on the right spot, right? Okay. Uhu Na is 4 times 2. And I'm still assuming Pala means left. If it's not, if this doesn't work, I'll have to change my idea on that. So Pala means turn left. Uhu Na is forward twice. Pala Na means turn left twice. Ra means move left once. Fam Ko means turn right 3 times. So right, right, right. And then Lam Ko means back 3 times. Hey! I was right! That was the one thing I was missing, is that you have to It means how many times you're rotating. Okay, and I just guessed correct, I guess, on the whole thing about balance. More strength for my strength guy, I guess. Not a super great reward, because I can craft those myself now, but hey, I have 9 lockpicks, because there was 2 in here. More lockpicks than ever before, and wow, how long have I been missing out on this revolver? And also, does it suck compared to the 19 to 57, 11 to 33, range 3, cooldown, that's reload. Reloads all 6 chambers of the revolver. Oh! How does that work? That's interesting. So, does that mean that I can... Huh. I think that means that I can rapid fire with it, basically. I think that means that if I have to manually reload it, but then I can just keep shooting. Oh, no, the cooldown's 1.5. So it still has a cooldown. So yeah, my repeater seems to be an all-around better weapon, but this could have been a really cool weapon to find earlier in the game, but I guess I missed my opportunity to use it properly. Oh well, that's this secret done with, the storage. Because I did the archive a long time ago, that was a very easy puzzle. So that's this pressure plate puzzle out of the way, finally. Now, we'll move on to, I don't know, whatever I have... Oh yeah, all the pyramid stuff. I think I finished my open world things. So we're going to go back into the pyramid and take care of all the loose ends that I left dangling, if I can. Alright guys, minor distraction. I was looking at my map here, just quick save first of all. And I remembered a dirty little trick here. It's this place, the rat ambush pit, which I left for so long, because it has this sign that says, I dare you. So, you know, let's follow up on that dare. Hey assholes, take this rock! And I'm about to shoot you the fuck away. Zoom. Oh, why did I cast that spell? I'm an idiot. Why did I do that? Fucking shoot the dude. Yeah, messing up. Oh, there's no one over there. I really thought there was gonna be a guy over there. Oh well. There's guys everywhere else. Oh, I can't move because I'm paralyzed. Alright, whatever. I figured since I was in the area, I might as well come back in here. Because clearly I'm gonna be high enough level to kill these dudes after all this time. So let's see if there's any cool loot around here. That guy just shot me! Fuck that guy! You should heal, buddy. Let's deal with that really quick. Oh, I can move now because you healed. Cool. Nope. Well, aren't you guys a bunch of pesky rats? I guess I should have seen that coming. Hey, asshole. Wanna fucking get shot in the face? Yeah, that's what happens. That's what happens to rats. I sound like a mafia boss or something. No, I don't. A mafia boss would sound tough or something. I just sound embarrassing. Hello, friend. You're gone. Anyone else? Anyone else? Are you not detained? So I need to figure out how to open that if I want to get back out. Hopefully this wasn't a waste of time, but either way, at least I finally went down here to check it out. Because I figured there might be a secret or some sort of reward, since whenever they drop you in a hole and make you fight somebody, usually they give you something for it. I have another shitty potion I can use on this guy to heal his wound. There we go. Let's just go breaking and exploring. I would have never remembered to come here again if I hadn't happened to come by to do the lexicanary thing. The weird platform puzzle. We have... Aww, cheese. I got excited because I saw cheese and I'm like, cheese! That's one of the things that makes people more powerful! And then I remembered that I don't have a rattling in my party, so the cheese is not super useful for me. I'll keep that sack around, though, in case I want to use it later, for sure. Is there a sack? Oh, that's a rope. I was like, did I put a sack inside of a sack? I didn't know I could do that. So we have, down there there's a whole extra area. There's a few teleporters in the room. I wonder where I'm gonna end up if I take some of these. Definitely wanna go over there and get that plant that makes me... Oh, it's a chart of healing. Okay. All right, these are on my mage now. I have 3 of those now, neato. So if something goes really bad against a boss fight or something, I can make my dead guys come back to life. I'm gonna try to save those kinds of shards for the final boss or any other big bosses, though, that are actually really hard. I don't want to use them against specific dumb mistakes. So we have a teleporter up here, and if I go downstairs, there's another teleporter downstairs. I don't know where either of them goes. There's also a weird chamber over here. Oh, a switch. What did that switch do? It must have opened something. But what did it it opened the teleporter over there. The teleporter I was by in the first place is now open. Let's take a quick look for secrets. I'm gonna be very disappointed if there's nothing in this entire place besides one crystal shard of healing. But at least I checked it out, I guess. Yeah, so this teleporter just takes you upstairs and downstairs. So that's not a big deal. I haven't seen any buttons, and I think this teleporter will just take me back upstairs. Okay, so that was it. I got to kill some rats, and I got a crystal shard of healing, but that's all that the I dare you trap really amounted to. Alright, see you guys back at the pyramid, which I should actually go to now. I know, guys, I keep saying I'm going back to the pyramid, but I took this route back out of the ruins of Desaru, and I went through the sewers, and I just saw this goddamn shrine is right here, and I don't know how to get to it. I also don't know how to get to the one that's all the way back. Like, I found the two shrines I'm looking for. The one in Sleet Island I don't have a path to yet, which I assume I unlock somehow. We'll see how that goes later, I guess. But the one right here is like in plain sight, and I don't know how to get there. But I've been looking at every single goddamn pixel of this map today, and I found something really important that might lead me there. If you look at this part, the southern corner of my entire map, there's a ladder going up a wall, and I never went up that ladder. I don't know what's on top of the ladder, so I'm gonna take a look at that, and hopefully that'll help me out, because otherwise, I don't know what the fuck is going on. So it's called Sewer Exit South, and there's just a ladder here, and I've just never gone up it. I completely missed this ladder. To be fair, sewer is a very crazy, weird zone, so where are we gonna be now? That is immediately the shrine, right there in front of me. Just like that? Just like that. Okay, that's all I needed. There's also an ogre over there, so I'm gonna have to fight, I guess. Sewer access south, yep. Okay, so we're gonna have a fight on our hands here, and some more healing potion materials, apparently. Silly ogre, though. I have a flurry of fireballs. Oh god, he still has his charge attack, I guess. I haven't seen him really use that yet. Ah, get out of here. Careful, I don't want to trap myself anywhere where I can't move around. Ooh, there's a head to talk to me. It's a talking head. Well, the days go by, water flowing underneath. Please die. He's not dying as fast as I would like him to. Come here, buddy. Take that hit. Yeah. Gotta be careful. Yep, they have side swipes. Yep. Gotta definitely be hitting them while they're entering a square and not any other time. Do I have the mana for this? Nope. Ow, he hit me anyway. Shit. Do a quick heal then, because I don't want them going down right now. He's dead. Alright. He dropped a giant club. I've been stockpiling those things in the hub, so I'll hold on to it. Wow, just like that, there was a shrine right here, and I haven't used it yet. If you wish to enter the crystal mines, you must take the way of the snail. Huh. I'll just go ahead and type that anyway, even though I already have entered there before. You wish to open... enter the Wow, I'm typing poorly. Mines, you must take the way of the snail. I believe that's just saying that the key to going into the crystal mines is that you have to walk slowly through their, through those pressure plates. Like, there must be a timer on them, and that's why the thing locks up on me when I'm trying to walk in. Makes sense, I guess. Makes me wonder how I got in there the first time, because I definitely didn't do that on purpose. Maybe I accidentally walked slowly, I don't remember. Where's my power gems, though? Ta-da! 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 Only need one more power gem and I'll have enough for the next shrine, too. Because I have three left. So what element are we getting today? Ooh. Startling. It's the essence of air. I'm gonna put it on the floor over here. Goodbye, essence of air. You can just stay there. I fought in your general direction. No, I'll hold on to it. Let's put it in here. There we go. Next time I go to the temple, I'll be sure to deposit that. And now I just need to get the last essence, which I believe is... It's surrounded by water, so I assume it's called the essence of water. Did they say anything new? This is the elemental shrine of air. Air is the rune of dexterity, storms, and flight. Northeast is where the forces of air are strongest. Follow the footsteps of Kilhagen the Wise. Bring forth four power gems and fuse them into the essence of the element. Not all of the gems lay under the sky. Some of them lay buried deep underground. I think this one is always the same note. I think that specific one's always there, but the other two change from each shrine, because I think they're always new. One of them always describes the element, I think. Alright, so we're done here. Let's see. Just for the heck of it, I'm gonna go check out the entrance to the crystal mines just to confirm that I know how to get in now, to see if it works. But yeah, I think next we'll finally make our way back to that goddamn pyramid to shave off what's left there. Alright, if you want to enter the crystal mines, you must take the way of the snail, so just go slowly? Just stand here for a while? And then forward? And then stand here for a while? Is this gonna work? Or is it gonna poison me? Alright, let's go. Hey! I did it! Alright, I don't need to do that though. But hey, we solved the entrance to the crystal mines, which I didn't even... Which the first time I saw that, I was like, that's gotta be a puzzle, right? And then I just walked in though, and nothing, there was no big deal. But clearly, it was supposed to be a puzzle. And here's some of the random bullshit I picked up that I've left around the various levels along the way. Might as well... I'm sort of stockpiling everything here now. There's all the throwing weapons, projectile weapons... Alright, we got a new projectile weapon. More cannons! And more throwing weapons. Armor of various kinds is just kind of strewn about everywhere. Wilson's here, because I don't think he's useful for anything, but he's kind of funny to keep around. Over time, I've actually been grabbing some of those stashes I've been leaving around and picking them back up and putting them in here. I wish you could position everything exactly where you want it to actually make things look cool, but everything on the floor moves around when you walk, unfortunately. So everything looks kind of like shit. But if we had a bunch of shelves everywhere, that'd be nice. But this is the most convenient place to stockpile things, because all the teleporters are here. So, let's finally go back to that goddamn pyramid. Oh right, we should put the, oh no. I was gonna say, we should put the element back on its spot. And of course, we have new friends everywhere to greet us, now that we've accomplished this. I've been casting dispel events against these assholes, but I bet fire works too. No it doesn't. Motherfucker. These guys are just annoying. I don't think they even really hurt me, they just are irritating to fight. Alright, dispel. Yeah, that was 30 damage. I'm glad this enemy's in the game so that I can't hurt him with anything. I have to just keep waiting for dispel to come back. Yep. Yep. You do that like one damage to me. It's excitement. I've never been more excited in my entire life. Alright, here we go. Holy shit, he's still alive. And now he's running away, though. Fuck that guy. Are you gonna ambush me again? Ah! No, let me go in! You piece of shit. Oh, you're showing up. You're probably here because I got the, ow, that's actually kind of hurting me. Get out of my face. Oh, he was inside me. Gross. I have to fight you because you're gonna keep shoving me around like a douche. I don't like you. Go away. Go away. I can't do anything to him, it's so frustrating. I have to keep trying to cast this one spell. Which does use some mana, so I have to keep replenish it to some extent. I'm in such a good mood right now. This is a dumb enemy. He just takes 500 years to kill. I guess if you're playing as 4 minute, this is like the one thing that's thrown in the game to make sure you don't play as 4 minotaurs with that just hit people with big weapons all day. Oh shit, I don't have a... I need to regenerate a little more. Obviously, I'm prioritizing my shittier energy potions. Oh man, the damage isn't even consistent, so sometimes this could take me a long time sometimes. Die. There we go. Jesus Christ. Okay. So, looking at my skill, this is fire. And that is mountain, so it faced this way for compared to the screen. So that should be a squiggle. Right. And that is lightning, and the bottom one is something else. I believe this guy's water, so this must be lightning. I mean, air. So, ta-da! Now I have air, and there goes water when I get it. But there's fire and earth. So I have 3 of the 4 elemental things in place. Just need to get the one more left. Open the door, motherfucker. Get in here. You put me here, I'll fucking take your organs out. I don't know. I'm just being stupid now. But hey, now we're gonna finally go to the pyramid, or will we? I don't know. Do you know? I've been saying it over and over again and then not doing it, so you shouldn't trust me is what I'm saying. Ah. Alrighty, first things first, we have this little puzzle here with the teleporter and trapdoor, and below that trapdoor is a room with a stat potion. And the idea is I want to figure out how to get down there, and someone suggested I could drop something down there. Yeah, like, if I put something on that platform, and then, put something else here, then maybe it would drop the thing before... Like, maybe that will successfully drop the thing before... What am I trying to say? Maybe the trapdoor opens first and drops the item, and then the teleporter activates, so maybe I'll be able to actually go down there, and, like, a pressure plate will be active or something, and I'll be able to access the place. So we're gonna climb down and see if things worked out for me here. Hey, there was a pressure plate, and the thing landed on it, and there we go. 3 poison bombs, potion of willpower, which I'm obviously giving to my spellcaster, because ta-da! And that's that thing off my list. Okay, let's see what else I can find. I need to find, oh yeah, next thing is I need to find the 6 sarcophagi room from before. Alright, you'll remember this being the crazy chamber where I had to figure out how to get past these things by putting on combinations of stuff. And in the room before here, we had the chamber with the 6 things in it. Did I walk past it? No, I didn't. Okay. This chamber with 6 things in it. I put a tail here. Go ahead and eat that. I guess I ate a tongue instead. Oh well. Where's my note? A gift for Burel the Hedonist. His bloated remains need 6 vessels. The attorney welcomes him. The mirror gauntlets. So let's go into my alchemist. His mirror gauntlets. And there we go. There's the thing I missed. Let's go blow some fools up, I guess. Or no one's here. We do have, is that 2 dexterity potions? Oh, vitality. And yeah, 2 vitality potions. That's interesting. I get it. Because he's a glutton. Because he's a glutton, our reward is a whole bunch of food items. I get it. What was this? Blueberry pie. Hey, achievement unlocked, piece of pie. Is that the only pie in the entire game? Would you really want to eat a blueberry pie that's from a place like this? Oh well. Take that thing back off. Put my gauntlets back in place. And speaking of taking things back off of offering spots, that's what we're going to do next. What is this note here? Yeah, I'll just throw it in my pile of notes just for sake of it. Alright, so that's the 6 vessels thing to take care of. Now I just need to go to the previous offerings that I used to open doors and just go get those things back. So, be back in a moment when I find where that was. Alrighty, we're back in this place where there's the 2 things on the side of the doors with notes saying where to deliver them, basically, for offerings to the dead. And since some of those items might have been actually useful, not that note so much, it may have been... It's worthwhile to come back and make sure I grab these things again, in case I want to use them again. So we'll just make sure I grab it. So we have the Wand of Fear. What was the other one? We had like a dexterity weapon, which I realize might not be as useful. Oh, hey, surprise, snake. Nice to meet you. Fucking stop living now. There we go. Taken care of. Surprise snake has been taken care of, and now I'm hobbled. God damn it, snake. No, it's great. It's what I was hoping would happen. Okay. And there we go, the dexterity weapon, Moonblade. 10 to 31 plus dexterity versus 13 to 39. So it's not as good now, but it might be better than my other hand. It is. So I could do these 2. There we go. Now I have 2 pretty alright dexterity weapons that I can dual wield. That's cool. And we have a Wand of Sphere, which I can give to my spellcaster as like a fun, I guess a fun trick weapon to use, because Wand of Fear. Let's see. Cloud of Nightmares. Yeah, it's like, it should terrorize people. I guess that'll make them run away or something. Either way, I have it, no matter what. And I have an upgraded dexterity weapon, so that was worth the trip. Now, let's go fight some golems. Here's a fun little random note I'm noticing. Underground here, there's one of those weird secondary ladders that goes deeper. I wonder if I'll find anything cool down. Ooh. Hey! It pays to glance at your map every now and then. Now let's figure out how to get back above water before I drown down here. I'm starting to think that if I want to get to the water shrine over there, I might need to just, like, hop in the water and run around for a while. And maybe if I run around for long enough, like, there's actually something in there. So we got the mirror pants, which is good for my, probably good for my, they're all items for my deck, for my gun guy. We have a willpower plus 1 necklace, which I don't think is very... Haven't I already found willpower plus 2 necklaces? That's kind of a shitty necklace, isn't it? We have better pants for my guy, though, because I've been wearing rogue pants, which has been handy for when I was using my bow and stuff like that for a while, but As someone who's built for firearms usage, it's not very handy to have him using anything besides just higher defense stuff, since the dexterity doesn't actually help him a lot. So, I'm giving him the mirror stuff over time, because he does have light armor now, and that makes his protection significantly higher. Unfortunately, it's also fucking heavy, so his weight's becoming a problem. Oh, really? It's this reed chest piece that's becoming a problem. I'll find the... Oh, yeah, I already have a mirror chest piece. It's back here. And it weighs 8, and this weighs... Oopsie. And this weighs 8. Oh, it weighs the same amount as the mirror one will. Shit. Okay, so this guy's getting... He's not even carrying anything besides these items, and he's getting too heavy. I'm gonna have to replan the... Oh, okay, I know what I can do. There we go. Someone else just has to carry his ammo for him, because he can't carry shit. That's fine. 40 shots for now will be good. Problem solved! In real time! Because I'm clever, I guess. I'm not actually clever. Alright, so, I'm gonna try to find my way back to the golems. Because one of these is the golem teleporter. It actually might be this one. Okay, lucky guess. I thought I was gonna have to cut away till I found something. So someone suggested, actually a couple people I think suggested, that I should kill the golems because they might drop something cool. I've just been concerned because they look so scary, like they're really dangerous. But let's blow up some mummies. As long as I only fight one golem at a time, I can probably figure it out. I am concerned about the idea of having to fight more than one at a time. Gonna get rid of those mummies. Oh, mummies dealt with. Wow. That is a scary attack. Is he immune to fire? Let's find out. Why, yes he is! So, let's never use fire against him again. Oh, the trickster's here! What the fuck are you doing here? No! Get out of here, trickster, I hate you! I don't need to deal with your bullshit right now, I have the scary golems to deal with right now. Don't you know when you're not wanted? Blow up the trickster! Trickster! You little piece of shit. You're trapped now. What are you gonna do? You're trapped. I'm about to get- oh, he's gone, okay. Fuck the trickster, man. Fuck that guy. Oh no, a second golem coming this way. I think second golem's coming this way. I just did 0 damage! Okay, I did some damage that time. Wow. Okay, let's move a bit. So the meteor weapon does 0 damage to this guy. And I don't think I brought a backup, did I? Oh, because the meteor just does fire damage. It does! It only does fire damage. That's not good. Okay. This is a bad situation to be in. I may need to backtrack. I just should have gave food to the wrong character. There we go. I may have to backtrack a bit. So I can deal with the fact that I have fire attacks on this dude. Let's see. Deal with some of these adds because they're in my way. Oh! He threw fire at me! He doesn't seem to hit very hard, actually. But let's... Alright, I'll see you guys in a bit. I'm gonna go back to the hub and pick up a different weapon for my hard-hitting guy, because... I don't want to fight without him when he only has a meteor weapon on him right now. All right, stone golems or fire golems or magma golems, take 17 or whatever number 3. Try this again. Oh wait, I should look up a water spell, right? That'd be the smart thing to do. Ice shards. That's the bottom row. That's probably my best water spell that I have because I haven't really focused on water, even though that was like the school of that I started off with. Also, look at this. This ancient claymore does cold damage. If they're immune to fire, maybe looks like they take good damage from cold. Oh my god, that was a bigger explosion than I was expecting. Alright, ice shards time. That only did 10 damage. That was garbage. Oh well, at least I can do this. God, I missed. Don't take that as an example of what I think I can accomplish in my life. Ow, 111. Jesus, the quantity of damage I just took is not ideal. Wow, 324. Okay, so, lead damage dealer by a mile is going to be my Minotaur. Wow. Let's give him some energy potions, yeah. I'll use the mage just to clear out the crowds of assholes that are gonna show up throughout the fight. The annoying thing is gonna be trying to not fight both of these guys at once. Oh god, am I in attack range? Okay. It's hard to judge his attack range because he doesn't look like he's quite... square-shaped? Ah, crap, I missed. Okay, he looks like he's too big to fit in one square, so it's not... Maybe? It's hard to tell. So I'm not entirely sure where his exact location is half the time. But anyway, Meteor storm! Let's just kill more mummies so that they don't get in my way. Gunshots! Oh wow, I hit the golem from here. Neato. You wanna just fucking die, dude? Oh, I missed. Shit. Fire attack coming! Okay. I need to try to focus fire on one of them if I can, because if I get mixed up between the two... Ow! Motherfucker! Okay, let's heal up a bit. Don't want this guy going down, he's my main damage dealer. Although I do have the crystal of healing. Also, it's really easy to just leave this place and come back healed, although the enemy might heal too. So that would not be ideal. Let's get ready to do a charge attack on this guy. Oh, he's down! Hey! Oh, he drops power. Those are important. Okay, I get it, guys. I get it. When you said that they drop something that might be important, they drop power gems. Oh, hello, friends. Nice to meet you. Get out of my life. Please die, all of you. Really, I could just grind like crazy by just murdering everything in this entire zone, which is totally doable. I wonder if the mummies respawn. There's definitely mummies showing up everywhere else. Alright, so that guy's taken care of. That was not too bad. Can I charge an attack? No, I can't, so I need to use a potion again. Probably just use one on this guy too, whatever. Meteor storm on these assholes! Yes! Experience! I'm just trying to clear out some of the extras because they could get in my way. I don't want to accidentally walk into a mummy while I'm trying to fight these guys. Wow, one hit down. Cold damage. Definitely useful. From this point on, there's fire behind me. Oop, missed. From this point on, I'm gonna run around with my meteor and my sword. Cause, so that I have a fire weapon and ice weapon. Because as we've seen clearly, there are times where having an elemental weapon can be bad for you. And so I don't want to just stick to one. Did I miss? I missed, didn't I? Look at him doing zero damage to himself. Ice! Yeah, that's effective. Do I have any cold spells? Wait, that is a cold spell though, right? I mean, it's weird that ice shards is so weak when my ice weapon is not, but I guess you could say that it's because it's just a weak spell in general, maybe? Oh, it's probably because I don't have any I probably just don't have many points in ice spells. That's all my spells, really. Yeah, so my spellcaster's not really useful for this fight, aside from clearing all the bonus mobs that are hanging out in the area, which is also handy. I like getting experience. That's a good amount of experience to just get spammed at you. There we go, he's dead. Okay, we're getting a little cleared out here. Just want to get some good attacks on this dude. Did he hit him or not? Did he miss? I'm not entirely clear on whether that hit landed or not. It's a very weird-looking enemy. He's hard to tell. I'm never entirely clear what his exact spot is. I'm also afraid to fight him directly sometimes. Is he about to melee? Oh, he's about to do an AoE. Okay, I thought he was about to melee me. Are those guys gonna die in the fire? Does that give me experience or him experience? There we go. I was just waiting for him to come in so I could hit him. There we go. I do good damage to him, so I should be fine. Just gotta be careful not to blow it. Keep using these shitty healing potions I still have left over from back when that was all I could make. I mean, mana potions is what I mean. Oh god, AoE. I keep doing that thing where I'm waiting for him to walk into the square that I'm facing so I can shoot him as fast as possible, but sometimes he'll, of course, AoE. And I missed! Why, game, why? Ow, Jesus. Okay, that did no damage to me. That did, like, 4 damage to everybody, so that's not a big threat. It's weird how little some of his hits do damage to me, when some of his other hits do tons of damage. I'll use a quick potion here, because there's like a crowd of zombies coming this way. Oh right, there's a pillar here. Hello, mummies. Just gonna deal with you guys. Oh, I was just swiping at nothing. Even the meteors kept going past those guys because they died so fast. Come on. I missed again, didn't I? Ooh! This guy's a dick! I don't like him! He's not invited into my house parties that I never have, because I don't like people. Man, I really enjoyed the visual element of killing people with an ice weapon and having the crazy ice... Oh no, the ice machine's on the fritz type of animation. Wow, I moved the exact number of spaces I needed to move in order to not get hit by that. Yeah, he's down! 1500 experience! And a meteor? Meteor plate! And golden key. So only one power gem, but I have another golden key. How many do I have now? Just two? They don't stack, do they? Do they not expect you to have more than one golden key at once? I have meteor plate now. Wow. What is this guy wearing right now? He has protection 12. Meteor has protection 18. All right. Congratulations, tank guy. You have a proper tank chest piece now. I give this 12 to this guy instead of 8. So now my Minotaur has plate, and I give this mirror chest piece to the guy that's currently wearing this dumb reed set, and I'll give the reed to my Minotaur so we can carry it better. So now this guy has my alchemist has 4 pieces of mirror items, so he has 8 protection and 5 resist per item. This guy has some plate, so he's got some more heavy armor to complement his crystal items and stuff. And this guy is wearing, like, full meteor now, except for crystal boots. Still haven't found meteor boots, have I? Yeah, still haven't found meteor boots. Just imagine someone with, like, I got a poison blade, and I've got a moon blade, and I'm covered in meteors! And this guy's got a meteor weapon, I guess. I guess it's a little uneven in its implementation. But let's not worry about that right now. How many more assholes are just wandering around out here? I have enough mana to cast another meteor storm, speaking of meteors. So I might as well just wander up to one of these packs of 4 and just get myself a nice little, 3,600 experience? There we go. 360 experience. Let's look at the map. The map's pretty filled in, right? So as far as I know, and feel free to comment in, but I don't think the zone really has any more secrets for me, because I have the poison weapon and I killed the 2 golems. At this point, it's just a big empty area where I can kill a lot of mummies, which, frankly, I have gone a long way towards succeeding at already. All that's left is a handful of random mummies wandering around. I think all the packs are dead at this point. I definitely prioritized those ones with my spells because I wanted to get more experience per mana. Alrighty then, that is the golems taken care of. So now all that's left is to check out the new zone. And also, I might go for a swim here and try to see if I can just find a secret about how to get into that shrine. Because I don't know. I'm still not sure how to get into that shrine, and that does bother me. Actually, yeah, Let's go for a swim right now. I'm sure we'll be fine. We're gonna die horribly, by the way. All right, just gonna try to go around the rim of this area. Because as we've realized, you drown relatively slowly, so I can do a little bit of exploring to figure out what the layout is down here a bit. And I'm gonna start drowning now. I quick saved, so even if I do fuck up and drown, I'll be okay in the long term. Is there like a deck here? There is a deck here. Okay, now I'm actually gonna start. Oh, there's a pressure plate. How do I pressure plate? If I put a dagger here? Okay, I'm gonna go back upstairs now, because everyone's trying to murder me. Oh no! Someone actually died. Well, I found something though. There's a crazy pressure plate thing happening over there. And it has a skull, which is exactly what I'm interested in getting, because that makes my Minotaur even more badass. But I'll be back in a moment, guys. I need to go take a trip to a healing crystal after that ordeal, which is all the way up in the top corner. Alright, so we're back right around where we were before, and Slick got petrified on the way back because of those annoying harpy guy, the annoying Medusa head things, but I'm not too concerned about that. I'm more concerned about figuring out what's going on here. Is there a clue? Hold your breath. Do I have to stand here for a very long time? Maybe? I don't know. I don't know what to make of this. Hold your breath puzzle. Wow. Apparently Orenko can hold his breath for a really long time, by the way. My mage. Can I not attack? Underwater at all? I can't attack underwater. It's a bummer. Okay, I'm gonna go back up now because I'm drowning. Hold your breath. I don't know what to make of that. I'm not sure how to get that skull. Is that all that's down there, too? Get out of my way, buddy. There's just a skull in there, I think, and maybe an item in the skull. It's hard to tell. There might be something glistening in there. But yeah, I don't see how to get that particular item. Oh well. Go back to exploring the area. Oh, this guy's still trying to be a problem. Go back to exploring the area to see if I find any indication of how the fuck to get to the elemental shrine or just other puzzles that are just kind of hanging out around the area. Slick is still paralyzed. Ooh, a box. You carry that. There's a whole bunch of This is like the broken bridge, right? Okay, now I need to find there's some ladder. Okay. How's the map look now? Hey! We've more or less circumvented the island with no ladders, obviously, but potentially a few more clues on how to get up. Oh, hey, another stash of mine. I might as well just pick that up to put it in the... Can I carry it? Yeah, I can carry it. What's in that bag? Yeah, it's all garbage. Whatever. More shit to put in my hub, though. Don't know how to do the hold your breath puzzle, but I could just keep going. All right, quick save in case I fuck up, because my party's not exactly fully healed at this particular moment. I was a little surprised to find that you can't attack underwater. I just picked up that fish and then put it down. Now it's just on the ground. That's great. That's great. I love it. It's so dumb. It's annoying that you can't fight underwater. Because that means that those guys could just be a general pain in the ass and you can't do much about it. Let's see, the puzzle says hold your breath. Yeah, I don't know what to do about that. And I've circumvented the island now and I've not found a way up. Although I didn't walk around here yet. I kind of got blocked off by that guy. Nope, still no ladder. So either there's a secret somewhere that I'm missing, or you can't go up from here. So my next priority is going to go to the cemetery and check out what's there. And, if I have any smart ideas, we'll come back to figure out more about this island. But so far, yeah, I don't see any ladders. Okay, yeah, let's go to the cemetery next. Thanks for watching, guys. This has been a hell of a extended cleanup session, I guess. But now it's time to actually go to a new zone. We'll see how that goes.